How's it going, everybody? Estas here. So in this video, we're going to break down the whole game plan for this upcoming week. I want to talk to you all about stocks I'm looking at, my thoughts on the market. I want to break down SPY and QQQ to see what happened last week and what I'm expecting for this week. And since it's currently 6:47 p.m. on the East Coast, the futures market is open, so we are going to look at the futures as well. So sit back, relax, take a sip of your bang. In this case, I'm sipping, what is this, a candy apple crisp. This is pretty good. First time trying it. And make sure to go down below and get your 2 free stocks from Webull and your $33 from M1 Finance. And let's get the party started, guys. So last week was a pretty interesting week. I mean, we didn't get any crazy move in either direction. I mean, on Friday, I guess, we did see a nice upward move. But before Friday, the first 3 days of last week, remember Monday was off last week, the first 3 days were pretty much consolidation days. You guys can see here, SPY was pretty much between 419, 420. We did dip down to about 416. I believe that was on Thursday. And like I said, on Friday, we did see a nice pop. And now we're right at a critical spot of resistance, right at that all-time high at $423.59. Hence why I have an alert right now at $423.50. Because I want to be notified the second this thing ends up breaking out of that all-time high, which I suspect it will do this week. And I'm not a godsend, I'm not some crazy fortune teller, but I mean, we're so close to all-time highs. I do believe there's a good chance we do hit all-time highs this week. And you guys can see this pattern here. I've been saying it every day pretty much on the channel. This is an ascending triangle pattern, right? We're making higher lows into the big resistance at 400. Geez, I can't talk today, guys. $423.50. And the way an ascending triangle plays out is it ultimately breaks out of the resistance, and then it goes and it hits higher highs. It's going to go bananas, and that is where, again, like I said, I'm suspecting those all-time highs to hit. So overall, last week was a lot of consolidation, but we ended up finishing the week on a very strong note. The bulls took charge and ended up going up 0.9% on Friday alone when it comes to SPY. So let's see tomorrow what ends up happening here. And as of now, the futures, quite honestly, are pretty boring. They're not doing anything. I mean, S&P futures are at break even. Literally, guys, they're up zero, you know, 0%, not doing much at all. We have, okay, now they're up 0.01%, still nothing much at all. We have the NASDAQ 100 futures, they're up 0.06%, they're up 8 points, nothing too crazy there either. And the Dow futures, let's see what those are doing. Okay, they're up 14 points, up 0.04%, really nothing much either for the Dow futures as well. So at this point in time, we're at break even for the futures, and I'm going to be watching these heading into tomorrow, of course, in the morning and throughout the night session tonight. We'll see how these end up panning out. And I mean, look, guys, if we get a big spike tomorrow pre-market, right? Let's say we wake up and the futures are up 0.5%, maybe 0.3%, 0.7%, whatever. That's going to be a good sign that bulls are taking over momentum, and we're likely going to hit those all-time highs, at least on SPY, maybe tomorrow or some point this week. And QQQ is a little bit of a different story. I mean, this one's not nearly as close to all-time highs as SPY is. QQQ is still about 2-3% away from those highs. But one good thing I'm noticing here is, let me just zoom in a bit so you all can see this. We did end up gapping above, or breaking above, 335 on Friday, and we ended up closing above it, maintaining it as a new support, which is so critical considering that was resistance, 335 that is, for a majority of the last couple of days of trading. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 days of trading, 335 has been resistance. So we broke above it on Friday, closed above it. And the tech stocks, I mean, the NASDAQ 100 had one heck of a day on Friday. It went up 1.7%. So I want to see if this momentum continues. I want to see if we end up filling the gap up to 339 here on QQQ. That's the high from back in the middle of February. Do we break that high? Do we break 339? From there, maybe we go 342, 343, followed by all-time highs, maybe mid-340s. That is what I'm thinking for this upcoming week, at least as of now, the way the futures are looking and the way that last week played out, technically speaking. So that's a quick little rundown of the futures, what I'm looking at, and kind of what I'm expecting for this upcoming week. And I'd love to know what you guys are doing and your thoughts on the market. As always, make sure to drop a comment down below. And if you all are enjoying the video, hit that like button. If you all are enjoying the video, make sure to subscribe to the channel as well. I'm making content like this every single day. And if you guys haven't followed me yet on TikTok, check that out. It's at StockSurfS. Same with Instagram. I'm very active on both of those platforms. And I don't really pitch my other social media platforms, but once in a while, I do shout them out just to get you guys follow me on all these different platforms that I am active on every single day, right? So let's talk about some stocks now. And there's a crazy thing that happened over the weekend when it comes to Tesla, Anonymous. We'll talk about that here in a second. And I was kind of out of the loop this whole weekend. I unplugged a bit. I didn't look at the news or go through, stocks or my apps at all, really. I was just chilling this weekend. And sometimes I like doing that. You know, I'm looking at stocks every day and it's good to just unplug, you know, and that's what I did this weekend. But I watched that Anonymous video. And man, I felt like I was watching a scene from The Purge or something. That was like a horror movie. It's pretty creepy. But we'll talk about that in a second. But first, GameStop, GME, and oh, by the way, a lot of stocks, companies, shall I say, are reporting earnings this week. GameStop is one of them, and this is the king of meme stocks, or at least it was. Maybe AMC is as of now, but, you know, GME, they're reporting earnings on the 9th, so what day is that? Tomorrow's the 7th, Monday, Tuesday's the 8th. Okay, they're reporting on Wednesday. And as of now, I'm not going to lie, guys, I like the pattern here on GME. We gapped up, we filled the gap to about 290, which we called out in recent videos. And since that point, we saw 2 days of selling. We sold off on Thursday and on Friday. And the closer we get to 230, right around this 50 SMA on the 4-hour chart, the more and more attractive I think this dip is on GameStop. And buying it before earnings, I'm not going to lie. And by the way, I'm not telling you to do any moves here. Always do your own research. But buying it before earnings might be a bit risky, but you could get rewarded. You know, that's the gamble of trading before earnings. It's kind of like a 50-50. But for me, I'm going to wait. I want to see what they report, what the management says, EPS, guidance, all that good stuff, revenue, of course. And I want to see if we end up holding 230, maybe even 220. Maybe we go down to 215. That'd be nice, too. And these could be levels, in my opinion, where we could end up picking up some shares on the dip, maybe for a continuation play. Because the truth is, this stock's breaking out. It's above the moving averages. It broke out of the wedge here. And I believe, obviously, the momentum's continuing. And this is simply a pullback in the bullish momentum, which, again, could be opening up a buying opportunity. So GameStop, I really like it this week. And maybe from 220 back to 290, that could be a move. Or maybe even from 230 to 290. So what do you guys think about that? And, of course, AMC is also on my list. This one has been crazy. You guys obviously know about it. It went from $77. Well, first and foremost, it went from $14 in the past couple of days to $77. And now on Friday, it closed at $47.90, went down 7% on Friday, and it actually went down even more after hours on Friday. And did you guys catch the CNBC video, the little slip up there? We had the woman, I don't even know their names quite honestly, but we had the woman and we had the man talking about the naked shorting, and you guys saw the look on her face. Oh my God, it looks like she saw a ghost. She's like, she was looking like this, guys. Look at me right now. So, yeah, I mean, I'm not going to get into all that right now. But look, I feel like AMC could go up more, quite honestly. I feel like there could be a massive squeeze, whether it's tomorrow, whether it's at some point this week. I feel like the roller coaster ride isn't over. And hey, I could be wrong. This could easily collapse back down to fair value, which is anywhere from $5, $10. I don't even know. But it could collapse. But I feel like the ride's not over. I feel like there could be some more upside, maybe back to the 60s, 50s, maybe 70s again. So I'm going to be watching AMC here after that crazy CNBC clip there where they were talking about all the naked shorting and, you know, what's going on there, which is funny to me, guys, and I'd love to know your thoughts on that. So watch out for AMC. Maybe, who knows, technically speaking, hey, if we end up taking out the lows from Thursday at about 37.85, if I pull up the 5-day, 5-minute chart, you'll be able to see it. If we take out 38.37, we break under it, right? Maybe we do see a downside move to about $30 right around this 50 SMA on the 4-hour chart. Maybe. I mean, that's very, that's a lot lower from where we are now. So I don't want to say for sure that's going to happen. But at that point, maybe buyers start stepping in, technically speaking. But then again, I mean, this stock is obviously not moving on fundamentals right now. And I feel like technicals don't even matter much either. It's really all about the manipulation of the shares, you know, shares outstanding, the flow, the short interest, them shorting shares that don't even, you know, exist and so forth. So there's a lot that could go on, and I'm thinking, hey, there could be more upside, and I'm going to be watching AMC for sure, and I'm going to be getting my popcorn just to watch AMC because, quite honestly, I feel like this is better than any movie that they're actually showing in their theaters, guys, watching the stock itself, right? So that's AMC. Tesla, which I just mentioned earlier in the video, anonymous. And this is a hacker group. They're obviously anonymous. I mean, they have the creepy mask on. What mask is that? Is that, it kind of looks like the Joker mask. I don't even know what it's called. It looks like the Purge mask as well. And they got the creepy, you know, the lines across the screen. They got the creepy voice changer. And I feel like I was watching a horror movie. It was a little 3-4 minute clip there. And they were talking about how Elon Musk, you know, they were pretty much threatening him at the end of the day, saying how he's ruining the lives of the average working Americans, or they didn't say Americans, but they said the average working people that are putting their money into crypto, and then he's some egotistical rich guy who's tweeting and, you know, manipulating the prices, making these average working humans lose their money. And he's saying how Tesla, they don't make any money from actually selling cars, which, hey, he has a point. I mean, they do make a lot of money from the credits, the regulatory credits. They make a lot of money from, obviously, Bitcoin, the profits from Bitcoin. So they did have a point there. And I don't know. I mean, is this going to affect the stock? I don't know. I really don't. And the scary thing is, what are they going to do? They said, I forget what they said at the end, but it was a threat to Elon Musk. What are they going to hack? At the end of the day, one thing that's always in the back of my mind with electric vehicles, and this could be a bunch of BS, I don't know. It's me being a conspiracy theorist, I don't know. But what I'm thinking is, could they actually hack the vehicles themselves? So let's say we're driving in a Tesla, then all of a sudden the Tesla gets hacked and then it starts going backwards, or it makes a crazy turn, or, you know, you're not controlling the car anymore. I don't know. This is what I'm thinking in my head, guys. It's an electric vehicle. It's operated by a computer system, software, and so forth. Well, it's not, I mean, it's It's a technology integrated car, let's put it that way. And I don't know, could this stuff be hacked? You know, could the car itself be hacked? Let's say Elon's driving his Cybertruck, then all of a sudden Anonymous pops up on the middle screen with that creepy mask and he takes over Elon's car. You know, is this going to happen? Highly doubtful, but this is the conspiracy theorist going in my head right now. And I'm sure you guys are thinking similar things. I'd love to know in the comments. But overall, that's kind of what I'm thinking. And I'm not going to lie, the whole Anonymous movement, it's pretty creepy. And I believe they did hack. I remember them from about 9 years ago, maybe 10 years ago or something. I had to look this up beforehand to actually see when it happened, because I remember what happened, but I forget the exact date, when they hacked the PlayStation Network. And I'm not sure if they did this multiple times, but this was back in 2011, I was reading, and they hacked the PlayStation Network. It was down for who knows how long, I forget, but these guys, they're smart, they know how to hack, and they know how to get into, you know, sophisticated platforms, if you want to put it that way. So we're going to be watching Tesla. I'm going to be watching Anonymous. Who knows what's going to happen from here? And the technicals on Tesla, we see a descending triangle. I've mentioned this before. We have a clear support at 550. We've been making lower highs into that support. And ultimately, the way a descending triangle plays out is it breaks the support and we end up seeing lower lows. Just like an ascending triangle, we break resistance and we end up seeing a higher high. So I want to see if Tesla does break 550, maybe this week, next week, some point in the near term future. And then from there, I would want to maybe add some shares or maybe buy some fractional shares. I don't know. I might end up adding, in the 400s, I might end up picking up some more shares to my position. So what do you guys think on Anonymous? I want to know. Seriously, drop a comment down below. And Chewy's another company I'm looking at this week. They report earnings. I talk about Chewy all the time here. And they report earnings here on the 10th, so 4 days away from today. So what is that, Thursday? And technically speaking, at this point in time, Chewy is under $78. Big resistance on the stock. And actually, it's really a big resistance from $76 to $78. And $76 held all throughout March through about the end of April, beginning of May. And you guys can see also right around 75, 76, it's right around the 180 moving average resistance here, which has been resistance ever since the end of February, which, wow, that's almost 4 months ago. So I want to see if Chewy breaks 78, hence why I have an alert there at 78. And from there, I do see upside maybe to about 80, 82, mid-high 80s, you know, anywhere in this range. That is where I think Chewy could end up making the move. So I'm watching this one. Ticker symbol CHWY. Fuel cell is another one. Ticker symbol FCEL. This one just, they just reported earnings. No, they didn't. They didn't, Stas. They report earnings this week on the 10th, same day as Chewy. And this one's interesting. I mean, look, it arguably got ahead of itself. And it's hard to say arguably. It definitely did. Let's just say it definitely did. It went from $1 back in October all the way to $30 just 4 short months later. Could you imagine if you put in, listen guys, if you put in $1,000 in October and you sold in February, right? That is that's $30,000 right there. You're taking $1,000, you're turning it to $30,000, just to give you some perspective there, roughly, right? From one to about $30, that's a 30x increase, roughly. And that is just ridiculous. And again, it got ahead of itself. And from that point, it went from 30 down to about $6. That was a drop of 80%. That is no joke, guys. And ever since that drop, it hit $6. That was back in the middle towards the beginning of May. It's kind of been slowly reversing course. And now we're seeing the 50 moving average crossing above the 180 moving average. That's signaling maybe more upside. That's a bullish cross or a golden cross, whatever you want to call it. That is a very good sign. Now, I just want to see if we end up continuing this rally into earnings, even after earnings. And the next big sticking point here is right around 1150, right? That was back, well, that was support back in the beginning of March, also in the end of March, early April. And obviously, once the support breaks, it becomes resistance, and that's why it's a big resistance right now. So I'm going to put an alert at, let's say, about $11 on fuel cell. I want to see if we do take 10 out, head into the 11s, and if 1150 breaks, like I said, that is where we could see a nice big pop in the stock. And who knows, if they do well with earnings, EPS, guidance, the management team says some good words, this could end up doing quite well. So that's fuel cell. The next one is Stitch Fix, SFIX. They also report earnings, I believe, is this tomorrow? Yeah, it's tomorrow. They report earnings tomorrow on Monday after market hours. And this, very similar to fuel cell, got ahead of itself from 25 to 25. Wow, all the way to $113 per share, and it went from 113 back to 36. That was a drop of 70%, and we're seeing a golden cross forming in the past couple of days on this stock, very similar to fuel cell. And there's been a lot of upside since then, right? Since that golden cross, the shift of momentum here. And now we're actually at levels that we haven't been at since the middle towards the beginning of March. And I want to see if we end up taking out the highs from the middle of March, right around $60.50. And who knows, with good guidance, EPS, all that good stuff, revenue, maybe Stitch Fix does end up breaking out here and seeing a nice rally, an extended rally at that. Or another thing that could happen is maybe we do pull back towards the moving averages right around $50, and we slowly start playing off of those. Either way, I do like the overall momentum shift in Stitch Fix, and for that exact reason, I'm watching it, and that is ticker symbol SFIX. TTWO, also known as good old Take Two Interactive. This one, we see a nice breakout. Well, we saw a nice breakout on Friday, up almost 4%. We can see overall the price action here is pretty bullish, right? We sold off from 185 to 160 a couple weeks ago, and we saw a ridiculous rally after earnings from 160 to about 190. And why I think this is bullish is because we hit 190, pulled back, and we held a higher low above the 180 SMA here on the 4-hour chart, and we had a nice squeeze above the 50 SMA on Friday, and we closed above it. Now, I just need to see a break above 185, so I'm going to put my alert down towards 185. I'm going to replace that 188 alert. Now, if we break 185 and we take out 188 as well, this is going to be a breakout stock, and it's already setting up as it is a breakout stock, or as a breakout stock, rather. And this is an ascending triangle as well. Clear resistance between 185, 188, but we're uptrending into that resistance. So TTWO, if 185 breaks, 188 breaks, there's no clear-cut resistance up till about 192 to about 195. And then if that were to break, we could see $200 on the stock again, whether it's next week. Well, I don't think it's going to be next week. Whether it's 2 weeks from now, a month, 2 months from now, overall, maybe 3 months from now, overall, TTWO, the trend is shifting, and this is looking pretty dang good. So overall, guys, that is it. I'm going to wrap up the video here. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you did, smash that like button. Make sure to subscribe as well and turn on that notification bell so you guys don't miss any videos I make here on YouTube. And if you all want my Patreon, or access to my Patreon, where I'm doing all my real-time buys, all my sells, all my call outs, whether it's trading options, short-term day trades, swing trades, long-term investments. Literally everything I'm doing is on Patreon. Plus, you get a morning update video and more access to me if you're a top-tier patron. That's linked down below, or you guys can go to StockSurfFest.com/Patreon. That is StockSurfFest.com/Patreon. And you guys can also get two free stocks from Webull. Those are valued up to $1,600. You simply have to deposit $100 and you get those two free stocks. Same with M1 Finance. Deposit $100, you get $33 from them, and those are linked down below, and they're literally free money to you. And if you don't like M1 or Webull, you can simply take out your $100 deposit and you keep the free money. Simple as that. So I'll catch you all later on. Thanks for tuning in again. As always, keep crushing the market. Stay safe out there, guys. Good luck this week. Peace out.